Hey guys, how are you? So I am here to finish up March. Yeah, because I'm filming this right after the end of the month. So I need to finish up March and then I need to start on April. So we're going to do that. I love the way this looks right here. It's just so pretty. I love it. All right. So I'm going to put some stuff on the back here and then it's going to be time to take these out. So I think I'm actually going to do that first since they have to come out anyway. Because it's the end of the month. Oops. And we're going to have to put new ones in here anyways, so. Alright, so we'll set February aside, and we're going to set the journal aside. And then let's finish up March, and then I can show you what I'm going to do for the start of April. And I'll give you a hint. You probably already saw yesterday's video, mono printing with crayons, so hint, hint. Alright. I'm going to flip this over to the back side, and I am late getting March finished because I had jury duty. So I've got my jury summons, and we're going to throw the envelope away, but I'm going to tape in my jury summons because why not? The question is, I think I want to just put it in. Like I could just put it in like that. I could do this with it. Yeah, that would work. So let's do that. Let's get some tape on there. Try not to flash the summons around too much. It's got an address on there. I don't need to be out all over the internet. All right, so we're going to put this right here. Jury duty was interesting, but I got dismissed before I had to go into the courtroom, so I think that was probably a good thing. All right, and then I'm going to take this business card. I went and visited the spa last week. And went out to dinner on the last day of the month with my daughter's boyfriend and his family to this really new, really great place in Campbell, California, Sorrel Italian Bistro. It's not a super big place, but I will tell you, if you guys are in the area, you should go visit it because they had really wonderful food. I think I'm going to put this recipe. There. I might want to just stick it there. Or do I want to cut pieces out of it? See, I have to decide. And I also, while I was at the bistro having dinner for Paulius's birthday, met this gal, Jennifer Prince. She's developing some new gift-giving items. Gift wrapping items, and she just by happenstance walked up to us and asked us, because she saw us giving Paulius presents, our opinion on her new product, which I won't mention because it's, you know, in development. But when I told her I used to work for American Greetings, she got a really interesting look on her face and gave me her card and said she was going to call me. So that was interesting. So we're going to keep that because that might be, I don't know what that means. But I think I have a couple of pockets in here. Don't I have another pocket in here somewhere? Yeah. So I'm going to stick this in this pocket. Or should I just put a pocket back here? Mm-hmm. Or maybe I should just... You know, I'm gonna just do that. And I'm going to... I'm gonna grab a paperclip. got a giant thing of them. I should use them. So let's put this here. Just like that. Let's keep the summons closed with another one. Yep. Let's cut out of this one. I need scissors. Okay. So we are going to cut out the name and address of the place. Sometimes that's all one part of the pamphlet or takeout menu, and some other times it's not. In this case, it's not. So I'm going to be sure to cut out the address and the name. And then if I haven't butchered it too much, I will cut out what I had, which was the risotto, which was delicious. And then we're going to give these a better trim. And it could just be that maybe you went to Panda Express, or, you know, maybe you went out to Applebee's. It doesn't have to be any place fancy, and it doesn't have to be for a fancy reason. Maybe you just had date night with your husband. Grab a takeout menu, grab a business card, and celebrate that fact that you did that by putting it in your journal and documenting it. I'm going to tape it in. I like to use tape runner if I can, or glue stick, because I don't have to wait for stuff to dry. I have no patience. Okay, I'm going to journal about these things and then get my stuff out to get ready for April, and I'll be right back. Okay, here is January, February, and March of this year in their storage binder. It does not in the least bit surprise me that I can't get one more thing in here, or that I have to use a rubber band. So it doesn't surprise me. But look at how wonderful so far the first 3 months of the year look. Just wonderful and colorful and interesting bits and pieces from friends and life. You don't have to, you know, go anywhere special to find and use and make a journal about your life that just is interesting to look at. February, I didn't go anywhere. And look at it. It looks so wonderful. So use what you have from everyday life, whether it is, you know, movie tickets, or maybe a label from a new, type of tea that you got that you love, or it can be simple things. It doesn't have to be complicated. You know, some of what we used in March in here is just from, you know, it's junk mail. It's nothing fancy. And look at it. It's just wonderful. Okay, so now we're going to put the binder back on this, the rubber band back on this. And when I'm done, I will put it out on the bookshelf in the front room. There we go. And now we are going to set up the journal for April and May. I do usually carry 2 months around in here. And so I pulled out of my stash. These are all pre-made. Somebody asked me recently about these. And there is, in the Getting Started video link list, is a video of me making these. These are made out of file folders. They're nothing fancy. And then I sewed the signatures together on my sewing machine. So I've got April. And I pre-decorated them a little bit. And so I'm going to, I put this extra rubber band around where the stitching is. So here's April. And that one's going to go on the left, and then May is going to go on the right. And I try, you know, try to make sure they're both facing the same direction. So I'm going to connect the two of them with a rubber band. Like that. And then slip these two, now that they're connected to each other, underneath this rubber band in the journal. And now I have the two signatures in my notebook. All right, so let's take April and let's start decorating April with a few bits that I have. Now we've got some of our crayon mono prints, so I'm going to use some of those. And I was going to cut them out, but actually I think I'm going to just tear them. And again, as I said in the crayon mono printing with crayons video, this is just dollar store drawing paper. It's nothing expensive. You could use printer paper. In fact, the thinner the better. I like the idea of the torn edges. So we're going to just tear all these, and I do have a couple of pieces of life ephemera to add to the journal that from things that we did this weekend. Now this one here was done directly on the paper, and then I ironed over it to sink the color and wax into the paper and get rid of some of that waxy stuff that's on the surface, so that if I wanted to write over it, I could. Similar to the mono printing with crayons. I don't know if I want to use that one yet. I know I want to use these. I went to the dentist, so it's not exciting or necessarily fun, but I did. And then we also, since we were up in Millbrae, California, love Leonardo's catering and delicatessen. Really great food. Fabulous food. Little mom and pop place. And it's kitty corner from my uncle, who happens to be a dentist, a very well-known dentist in the area. And so if you need a dentist, go visit Bronzini Dental Group. And if you want a sandwich before or after you visit said dentist, go over to Leonardo's. Really great place to visit. So I grabbed one of their menus on my way out. And by the way, this menu is on really thick, nice, glossy paper. So... all right, so let's get these in here. Now, because I want these to be in here and flat in here, and I want to be able to maybe, as the month goes on, write over them, put pictures over them, I'm going to use matte medium to really stick them down really well. And look how well that collage is down. So nice. Okay, let's see. So I'm going to just not think about it too much and stick my collage elements in here. Now, as my week and or month goes on, I may come back in here, probably will come back in here, with other crayons, paint pens, markers, and that sort of thing. So I'm trying just not to use too much matte medium and to not get it too wet, so the paper doesn't wrinkle too much, but also so that it dries pretty quickly. And then as soon as I get this done, we're going to grab something that we can use to add in our book club list, because we're going to need to add that in for the week. Which, of course, I haven't read my, as of the filming of this, haven't read my books yet. So, you know, I seem to be doing them at the last minute, so that's fine. Okay, so that's done. So we've got our crayon embellishments in. So let me go find something to use for the book club and I'll be right back. Okay, we're gonna use the Leonardo's menu for the book club list, and I'm gonna tape the menu in, maybe. Hopefully this is not gonna be one of those kind of tapes that just does nothing but rip and drive you crazy. I'm gonna just stick it on here. It is some cute old-fashioned cooking utensil tape, but that only goes so far if it's gonna rip all the time. Alright. So I'm gonna run some along the edge of the menu. And then stick it to the edge of the paper. I'm gonna leave about an, I don't know, 1/8 of an inch or 1/16 of an inch gap so that it'll fold nice. And then put another piece of tape. This is nice sticky washi tape, so I shouldn't have to put any extra glue like I did last month. Okay, so that'll go like that. Maybe. I might need to trim a little bit off of there. I'm going to take this other part of the menu and I'm going to stick it here. So let's take some tape runner. Oops, wrong way. And then this is their phone number. So I don't want to lose any part of this. I want to save it all. So. Okay. Let's trim a scotch of this off. A scotch is a measurement term, right? I think it is. Okay. Yeah, that's better. All right, so now on the back side of this, we're going to put our book club list, which I printed. These are a free download in the files. There should be a page in there for free downloads. If you're new to my year 2017, we do book reviews every month. We decided when we started planning for this whole thing that the majority of us, if not all of us, you know, we have this giant stack of books we buy for various reasons. They're not even all art books, to read someday, but we never read them. So someday, we're done waiting for someday. We're going to read them now. So I'm going to tape it to the back of the menu. There we go. The card for my dentist. It's part of what happened this month. So we're going to stick it in. All right, so that's going to go there. This is going to go right in the front because I did it first thing. And that's interesting so far. Now, April, my mom's birthday is April 18th, so. And Polyus, my daughter's boyfriend, is April 2nd. And in my immediate world of family, people that are, you know, the immediate family, that's all that I'm aware of that's in April. It doesn't mean I'm not missing somebody, because, you know, I frequently miss somebody. All right. Now, talking about crayons, markers, and pens this month, you know, it doesn't have to get complicated. I'm always harping on you all about that. I know, and I know you're probably all sick of hearing it. Just, you know, get a highlighter crayon. These are, of course, the Bible Gel Highlighters. You know, y'all know I like them very much. And they are a highlighter, so you can use them to just go in. I don't document every little thing in my calendar. I just document the important things, and you can go in then after you write down what it is, like birthdays, and highlight that square that day in celebration. Now, these pens do not like to write over this highlighter crayon, just like any other crayon. It's not, you know, great for writing over, but you can, of course, write on the outside of it and doodle on the outside to further highlight that day, of course, right? So, simple, easy, not complicated so far embellishments. I haven't done too much. I may go into some of my embellishments here, the mono printing with a crayon. And you can further highlight the image by using one of these other. You could go in here with a paint pen. You could go in here with a gel pen. You could go, these are, of course, the Bible highlighters. Because you've melted off the most of the wax and you've just left the pigment behind on those crayons, you can do a lot. You could go in here with gelatos. A lot of things you could go in there with. It's just another way to, you know, embellish your journals. And you can see I'm not being precise, I'm not being exacting. I'm just having fun and playing. I'm not really thinking about it too much. So that's, I didn't do too much. You see, it doesn't have to be complicated. It can be simple. All right. So that is what I've done to close out March and set up for April. I will be back with more stuff, more work with pens, markers, and pencils and crayons, and also the book review and anything else I can maybe think up. We'll see how as the week goes along. All right, that's it for right now. If you're not part of the My Year 2017 Facebook group and you'd like to be, to see what we do with this and to be part of the group and chit-chat with like-minded friends, or you want to send me happy mail, or you want to be part of my other Facebook group, or support my channel by shopping in the Etsy shop, any of those things and more is in the description of the video. So please check that out before you go anywhere. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And of course, the most important thing, do something nice for yourself because you deserve it. And I'll see you later. Bye, guys.